Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So in our previous lecture we have discussed about a different agriculture practices. So today we will discuss deeply the first agriculture practice, that is nothing but what? Preparation of soil. Okay, the preparation of soil today we will discuss in deeply. So this preparation of the soil is done by the two processes. Okay, so why this preparation of the soil is important? Because as we know, if you want a good yield, if you want a good production of the crops, then we have to prepare the soil for that. And the preparation of that soil is done by the two processes, and these two processes means nothing but what? Ploughing and leveling. Okay, ploughing and leveling. So with the help of the ploughing and the leveling, we can mix or we can prepare the soil for the further activities of the agriculture. So let's discuss first, that is ploughing. Okay, what is mean by ploughing? Ploughing, the process of loosening and turning of the soil is called ploughing or tilling. Okay, so what is mean by ploughing? The process in that what we are doing, we are loosening the soil. Okay, we are loosening the soil and also we are turning the layers of a soil. Okay, so the process in that what happened? The process of loosening and turning of a soil is called ploughing, or also it is called as what? Tilling. That process is called as ploughing and tilling. So basically in the ploughing or the tilling, what we are doing? We are loosening the soil, or we are preparing the soil, or we are making the soil ready for the production or the sowing of a seeds. Okay, so that process is called as ploughing and a tilling. So why this ploughing or the tilling process is important? Why we have to do that? So let's discuss why this ploughing is important. What are the importance of ploughing process? Okay, so let's start. Ploughing. So the ploughing helps. The ploughing is what? Loosening of the soil. So this loose soil particles have more air space. Okay, so once we loose the soil. Okay, so ploughing means what? To loose the soil, and that loose soil contains the more amount of the air, which helps the root of a plant to breathe very easily. Or with the help of that loosening soil, the roots of a plant can get the more amount of the air for the breathing process. Okay, next one. Loose soil particles hold more water for a longer duration. Okay. So once the soil gets loose, it can hold the water for the long period of a time, and in this way the root of a crop plants can absorb the water for a long period, or they can absorb the more and more water, or the excessive water they can absorb. Why? Because the loosened soil can hold the water for the long period of the time and it cannot drain out from the soil. It holds the soil, or the soil can hold the water for the long period, and that's why the roots can absorb the maximum amount of water. Okay, now the third one is what? Loosening soil helps the root to penetrate deeper through the layers of soil. Okay, so once the soil get looser, the roots can easily penetrate the land. It can go deeper and deeper, and this also helps the root of a soil to fix into the soil. Okay, so the soil is loose, and that's why what happens? The roots can easily penetrate. Penetrate means what? They can go down into the earth. They can make a hole and they can go down into the land. Why they can go very easily? Because how? The soil is what? Loose, and that's why the roots can penetrate deeper through the layers of soil, and this helps the root of a crop plants to hold the soil or to remain fixed into the soil. Okay, now the next one we'll discuss, that the loosened soil helps, or it can mix with manures and fertilizers more easily. Or that loosening soil, okay, the loosening of the soil can helps to get, or the manures and the fertilizers can easily get mixed into the soil because of the loosening of the soil. Okay, so this is some points we have discussed. Now the next point is that the loosened soil helps to remove weed from the field. Okay, the loosened soil helps to remove weed from the field. Weed means what? The unwanted plants are called as what? Weed. So once the soil gets loosened, we can easily remove the weeds from that soil or from the field. Next one, The loose soil promotes the growth of useful soil microbes. Okay, so as we know, the soil contains different types of the microbes. Some of the types of the microorganisms are present in the soil also. Okay, in that some microorganisms are useful for the soil. Okay, so once we loosen the soil, it helps to promote the growth. Means because of the loosening of the soil, the growth of the microorganisms get increased. Useful microorganisms growth get increased, and which makes the soil more fertile. Okay, which makes the soil more fertile. Now, how it makes the soil fertile? How the microbes activities happens in the soil? So, as we know, there is a earthworm, and the earthworms are living in the soil. So, because of the loosening of the soil, what happens? The earthworms are also making their food. Okay, and in this way, what happens? They are burrowing the soil and they are making the channels. Okay, or they are making the holes in the soil. So with the help of that hose, what happens? The roots of a crop plants can easily goes down. Okay. Also, one more thing we can say that the excreta of the microbes or the earthworms are very fertile. Okay, are very fertile. They act as a manure. So the urine and the excreta of a earthworm makes the soil more fertile. Okay, and the growth of the microbes and the other microbes and the earthworm can get promoted with the help of the loosening of the soil, and that is the reason the earthworm is called as what? Farmer's friend. Or also the earthworm is called as what? Nature's gardener. Okay, so in this way, the loosening of the soil helps to promote the growth of useful soil microbes. Okay, it helps to release the certain types of the fertilizer, certain types of the humus, we can say that, or certain types of the manures in the soil, and helps to make the soil more fertile. Okay, next one we discuss that it helps to brought up nutrients rich soil up from lower levels of soil. Okay, so as we know, there is the some portion or the some layer of the soil which is rich in a nutrient. Okay, so because of the plowing, what happens? The rich in the nutrient, the layer of the soil which is rich in nutrient, it comes up because of the plowing. Okay, so because of the loosening of the soil, what happens? The nutrient rich soil comes up from the lower levels of a soil. Okay, so this is all about plowing. Plowing means what? The loosening of a soil we are doing. But how we are doing that, or how to plow the soil, or how to loose the soil, what we have to use? Yes, so this loosening of the soil or the plowing of the soil is done by the one type of an instrument, that is nothing but it is called as what? Plow. It is called as plow. Okay, so this plow is drawn by the bulls or some other animals, or also it is driven by the tractors. Okay, so these, how it works, which are their different parts, these all things we are going to discuss in our further lecture. But this plowing of a soil or the loosening of the soil to make the soil loose, basically we are using the one type of the instrument, that is what? Plow. And this plow is drawn by the bulls or it is driven by the tractors. Okay, so this is all about plowing. What plowing is? What the process of loosening and turning of soil is called plowing or tilling. And why this plowing and tilling is important, why we have to make this, that we have already seen. Now we will discuss the next process in the preparation of the soil, that is nothing but what? Leveling. So let's discuss about the next point from the preparation of the soil, that is the leveling. Okay, so as we know, the preparation of the soil is having the two parts, that is plowing, and the next one is what? Leveling. So the plowing already we have discussed, and now we will discuss about the leveling. Okay, after the plowing of the land, the plow land is leveled and pressed lightly with the help of a wooden plank or iron leveler. Okay, so you can see in the image there is a leveler. Okay, with the help of that we can level the soil, or we can do the leveling of the soil. Okay, so why it is necessary after the plowing, why we have to do the leveling process, and what is happens in the leveling process? The plowed land is leveled and pressed lightly with the help of a wooden plank with the help of that we can do the leveling of a land. Okay, so like the plow, this leveler also can be driven by the animals or it can be driven by the tractors in the field. So why this leveling is important or why we have to perform the leveling process in the field? So let's discuss what are the importance of leveling. First one, the plowed land or the plow field may have a big pieces of soil called clumps. Okay, so once we plow the soil or once we plow the field, then it makes the big pieces of a land, and that big pieces of a soil or the big pieces of a land is called as what? Clumps. Okay, so it is very easy to understand, in that clumps we cannot sow the soil properly. To sow the soil into the land, we have to make the soil in a proper manner, or we have to make a proper leveling of a soil. Okay, so it is necessary to crush these crumbs. Okay, and to crush these crumbs, the leveling process is very important. Okay, so why this leveling is important? The plow field may have big pieces of soil that is called as what? Crumbs. And that need to be crushed. Why it is need to be crushed? Because we have to do the soil in a proper manner. We have to make a land proper leveling, and in that level land only we can sow the soils or we can sow the seeds very properly or easily. Next one, the leveling of the soil helps to prevent the soil erosion. Okay, the leveling of the soil helps to prevent the soil erosion, because the level soil cannot be drain out with the water, it cannot be blown out with the high speed of a wind. Okay, so in this way it prevents the soil erosion. And the next one is what? The leveling helps in the uniform distribution of water and manure. Okay, so leveling of the soil is helps for the uniform distribution of water, that is nothing but the moisture which is present in the soil, that is what? Water, or you can say the moisture and manure. Okay, so leveling helps for the uniform distribution of water and manures. Okay, so in this way this leveling process is also important for the preparation of a soil. So basically for the preparation of the soil, we have to plow the soil with the help of the plow, and we have to do the leveling of the soil with the help of the leveler. Okay, so by performing these both the methods or both the agriculture activities, then our soil is ready for next agriculture practices. Okay, so in this way first we have to prepare the soil for the further agriculture activities. Okay, so here today we have discussed about the first method of agriculture, first practice of agriculture, that is nothing but what? Preparation of soil. In that we have discussed about the plowing, and also we have discussed about the leveling. And the next agriculture practices we will discuss in our next video. So it's time to tell you goodbye. I will see you in the next video. For today, thank you.